Now we will see regarding the principles of sabermeter and coronometer. These are the instruments which are utilized for the determination of the skin conditions. The first instrument is called as the sabermeter, which will measure the level of sebum in the skin. So nowadays many cosmetologists as well as many dermatologists, they are using the support of these sabermeters for determination of the exact condition of the skin. So here sabermeter is another one instrument. This instrument is for the determination of the sebum level in the your skin surface, as well as it can be utilized for the determination of the sebum content from the scalp as well as the hair. The principle behind this instrument is that this instrument measures the sebum level on the basis of the principle of grease spot photometry. So this is the basic principle of this instrument. The measuring head of the cassette with its specific tape is placed on the skin. So there is one instrument that is called as the cassette, which is placed on your skin to take the or to collect the sample of the sebum. And then after that, this cassette is inserted into the device. After the insertion of that cassette inside the device, it will measure the amount of that sebum. Generally, there is the principle is like that your spectrophotometer. The instrument measures the your content on the basis of the intensity of the light passes through the, your sample. So after the placing of your cassette inside the instrument, there is the light will pass, or the beam of ray of light will pass through this tape which is present in the cassette, and then the photocell measures the transparency of your cassette. A microprocessor is placed in that instrument. It can calculate the result. Generally, it will display the content of sebum in milligram per centimeter square of your skin. The instrument is generally utilized by various fields or various healthcare persons, like sebum content is measured by your cosmetologist. Then dermatologist also is taking the support of that instrument. The objective clinical studies are there. In that also, this instrument is utilized. Here they will monitor the course of the skin changes. So various research organizations are there on the skin. They will use this instrument. Generally, it can be also used for the support and efficacy testing of all kinds of cosmetics and other type of products also. Generally, other products which are utilizing for the your skin purpose. So whether they are having the good efficiency to stop the sebum or to control the sebum level of your skin or not. So in that case also, we can take the help of that instrument, whether that product is having ability to control the sebum level or not. So anti-acne products are also there. Shampoos are also there. Hair care products are also there. We are using them for the cleansing purpose. So after the cleansing, generally the sebum should be removed from your skin. So before application of that product, we can take the level of the sebum, and after the application of that product, whether the sebum is controlled or whether it is minimized or wash out or not. So that can be also measured by using this instrument. Then the instrument is having the such kind of photograph and such kind of this principle. Generally, it consists of one mirror-like structure inside your device. After the placing of that cassette, generally it will transmit the one ray that is called as the projected ray. And after that, it will touches to that sebum film or the sebum layer which is placed on the cassette or the tape. Then after that, it will transmit that rays from that tape or from that sebum film, and then that ray will again reflected toward the cassette and it will catch it by the photodiode. So the principle is near to same as like as your spectrophotometer. Then how much amount of ray is again reflected, that will measure the amount of your sebum present in the your instrument. So this is about your sebometer. Then another instrument is the corneometer is there. This corneometer is utilized to measure the amount of water level inside your skin. So this corniometer is having the good, very good results, like accuracy is there. Generally use the measurement of the hydration of your skin. There is a very quick time is required for the measurement purpose. Then it is having the, you can say, fast action or the fast results will be produced. The constant pressure for exact reproducible measurement are not influenced the skin. This instrument utilized for the determination of the hydration of your skin. The principle of instrument is that this corniometer measures the your hydration on the basis by utilizing the capacitance. Generally, capacitance is measured by using this instrument on the basis of dielectric medium of the, your skin. Generally, it uses the fringing field capacitance. Sensors are utilized to measure the dielectric constant of the skin. Generally, the dielectric constant of the skin can be changed with the presence of water content. As the water level is minimized or increased, then dielectric constant may be changed. The changes in the water content of the stratum corneum are converted into the arbitrary units of hydration. So on the basis of that hydration, the skin will develop the dielectric constant, and then that dielectric constant will be measured in the form of capacitance with the help of sensors by this instrument. The probe is utilized here. One probe or the one instrument is there that is called as probe, which is having the one fine piece of glass, which will give the sample of the your skin, and then after that it will be utilized for the identification of the how much capacitance are there. The measurement time is near about 1 second, and the depth of measurement is 10 to 20 micron. The stratum corneum sample will be taken on the glass slide using that probe, and it will give the exact amount of the hydration of your skin. Generally, this instrument is utilized for the various kind of products which are utilized for the your moisturizers, or the any kind of skin care products are there. Then it can be utilized for the clinical assessment also. It is also utilized for the monitoring therapies also. Then it will give the information on the course of treatments. That is the, you can say, very large research are going on, especially on the skin, which are utilized on the basis of the hydration of your skin. Then this instrument is also suitable for the medical surveys, as well as it is utilized for the assessing the hydration conditions or the range of the various research publications also. This is the same instrument having the such kind of diagram. There is one probe, there is conductor, then tract, and the near about principle is same. Here the one ray will be reflected on this collected sample, and then depending on the reflected ray, how much ray is passed from your sample, it will count the amount of that material. Then another one is there, that is the called as the TWL measurements, that is the transdermal water loss. So how much amount of water is lost from the your skin, that is calculated, that is called as the TWL measurement. The TWL measurements allow the to discover the disturbances in the skin. Generally, the normal skin allows the water loss only in the small amount. But sometimes there might be possible that skin may lose the maximum amount of water due to the any kind of skin problems. The determination of this transdermal water loss is an important support to the investigation of the skin, that is sometimes in case of the irritation, sometimes in the allergic conditions or any kind of chemical influences occurred with your skin. So in that case, we can find out the parameter that is called as the transdermal water loss. If the water loss is more, then we can get the assurance that there is a problem with your skin. The typical fields of application of this instrument is the in case of the your allergic conditions, in case of the various your skin problems, in case of the observation of the newborn skin, then supervision of the healing process of the skin damages, as well as in case of burning case, then we can check the effectiveness of the various products, then biocompatibility of various cosmetic products by using this instrument. Generally, whatever the products we are utilizing for the skincare purpose, so they may affect on the your loss of the water from your skin. So in that case, how much amount of water is lost, that we have to measure by using this instrument. So by this way, indirectly, we can use this instrument for the various purposes. So these are the three instruments we are utilizing in the determination of the various skin conditions. So this TEWR instrument is measure your loss of water in your skin. There are the two methods by which we can use the your loss of water from your skin, that is closed chamber methods as well as the open chamber methods. Generally, the chamber is utilized by using the micro sensor. The housing or the chamber is placed on the your skin, and after that one micro sensor will touch to the skin. When the housing is kept on the your skin, generally it will stop the evaporation of the water from the skin, and it will measure the, it will develop the humid condition in that inside that chamber. So how much amount of humidity is developed, so that humidity will be calculated by that chamber on the your skin. Then it will give the result that how much amount of water is getting evaporated from your skin, and then it will give the idea that how much amount of water is getting lost from your skin. So this is the one chamber is developed with the help of sensors. Once that this chamber is kept on your skin, so due to the close that chambers, the whatever the water is coming from the skin in the form of vapor, it will be stopped, and it will be catch in that chamber itself, and that vapor will convert into the humidity, or the water will get, that vapor will get condensed. Then after that, how much amount of that water is present there, that will be calculated by using the sensors. So these are the three instruments generally we are using for the determination of the various your skin care products or their efficiency. So today we have discussed about the principles of sebumeter and corneometer, as well as we have discussed about the TEWL factor, and then today we'll see the remaining part, like that is skin color, hair tensile strength, hair combing properties. Now in the skin color, it is the, you can say, one factor of your skin depending on the your pigments present in the skin, that is the melanin and hemoglobin as well as the carotene. So they are generally decide the color of the skin. Generally, the excess amount of the carotene can also cause the yellowish color of your skin. The skin color is generally measured by using the two instruments, that is called as the telespectrodiameter and spectrophotometer. So spectrophotometer is recently evolved for the measurement of the tone of the color of the skin, but previously telespectrophotometer was utilized. This is the telespectrodiameter, instrument utilized for the determination of the skin tone or the color. And the principle behind the measurement of the color is that the lamp will introduce the light, or the beam of light will pass through the skin from the sample, and then it will be transmitted to the another direction, and then the diffuse amount of that light will be calculated by using the photodetectors. So here directly that instrument will be applied with your skin, and then beam will be passed and they will measure the tone of the color. There is another scale is developed in 1975. It will give the idea about the skin type depending on its color. So amount of pigments which are present in the skin, generally it will give the color, as well as the skin color will also react with the sun exposure. The information which is obtained by using this scale, we can have the prediction regarding the overall risk about the sun damages as well as the skin cancer. So this scale is called as the Fitzpatrick scale. So this Fitzpatrick scale will have the different types of skin tone, that is the depending on the pigmentary phototypes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So this scale is start from fair to the dark. So depending on the epidermal melanin, the color of the skin will be changed. As the concentration of epidermal melanin get increases, the color of the skin becomes dark. As well as the UV phenotype, if we'll think about the regarding the exposures of your skin and possible hazards to your skin, depending on the fairness and darkness of the color of the skin, the sensitiveness of the skin will be decreases if your color of the skin is having the fairness. As the your skin color is become dark, or the tone of the skin is becoming dark, then the resistance toward the sunlight is increases. As well as if the skin of the color is little bit dark, or it is toward the dark, then there is the very low risk of the skin cancer, as well as there is a low risk of the burning, or the dark skin will never burn. But in case of the fair skin, the burning chances will be there, as well as the UV sensation will be more, and the risk of cancer will be the more. So this is called as the Fitzpatrick scale for the determination and prediction of the possible damages to the skin, as well as the possible chances of the cancers. Now the next point is the tensile strength of the hair. So already we have discussed about the structure of hair, as well as the various kind of products we have utilized for the hair care purpose. The tensile strength of the hair is defined as the maximum stress or force per unit area when we are applying, and in the same condition your hair will remain as it is, or it will withstand while you are stretching your hair or while you have pulled your hair. So the ability of your hair withstanding without breaking, that is called as the tensile strength of your hair. As well as when the hair is breaks when we are applying the too much force, so the breaking force which is we have applied, so that breaking force will give the ultimate tensile strength of your hair. The tensile strength is an important property of materials. It is applied for the very much types of other strengths also. It will be applied for the other type of material like wires. It will be applied for the ropes, as well as the metal beams. So by giving the pressure or by stretching that material, we can find out the tensile strength of that material. In the same way, we can find out the tensile strength of your hair also. So here, for example, I have given the one procedure. Simply you tie the one hair to the one pencil, and another side we can bind the particular weight, and on that weight we can find out the whether your hair will be broken or not. Then if the hair is not broken, then we can add the extra weight and we can try to find out the whether hair will be the broken. Again we can add the weight. So at which weight your hair is break down, so that weight we have to mention, and then we have to find out the diameter of the hair also, and then we can calculate the ultimate tensile strength of the hair. The tensile strength of the hair is lies between 152 plus minus 33 millipascal, and the fracture may be find out at the 32 plus minus 9 millipascal. So this strain rate increases the tensile strength of the your hair, and it is increased near about 267 to 45. The formula of tensile strength is called as sigma is equal to F upon A, that is the force per unit area. Now to give the good health to the your hair, so how to go for the combing. Now combing is the routine process. So to make the your desired style, we used to go for the combing of the hair. The hair combing is the basic day-to-day task, as well as it is little bit critical factor also, or it is little bit critical task also. And the routine combing of hair will have the lots of advantages. It will promote the hair growth. It will give the also good health of the scalp also. It will stimulate the scalp for the hair growth, as well as it will avoid the breaking of the hairs if you are routinely doing the hair combing with the proper way. As well as the hair combing stimulate the scalp, and it will give the help, or it will promote the hair growth of the your hair. Generally while making the combing, we have to follow the some rules. So there are the some tips for the combing of the hair, so which will avoid the breakage of the hair, and it will stimulate the production of the hair. Generally we should use the wide tooth comb for the long hair. Sometimes if you are using the small comb with the small tooth, then it can cause the damage of the hair. As well as while combing of the hair, so when we have taken the bath, the wet hair should not be combed, or when we are trying to combing of the wet hair, then we have to take it very carefully. Actually the wet hairs can be combed very fastly, but it creates the tangles and it can cause the breakage of the hair. The better way to comb the hair, that is we can dry the hair after 5 to 10 minutes with the natural light, or the with the natural warm, we can go for the drying of the hair, and then we can comb it. So it will be the better one. Then another tip is that we should avoid the maximum shampooing. So try to use the less amount of shampoo, or do not use the shampoo. So it will give the good impact, and it will result in the good shining of the hairs, and it will avoid the breakage. Then another tip for the good health of the hair is that we should use the very limitedly electric styling tools. Nowadays in the parlors we are using the electric instruments for making the styles of the hairs. So if we are avoiding such kind of tools like flat iron, hot rollers, curling irons, so generally these types of instruments can damage the your hair, and it will not give the proper growth of the hair. So avoiding of such kind of instruments can give the good repairing life and good life to the hairs. So this is about the hair combing. Now, causes of dry skin, like there is a frequent and steamy baths. Suppose anybody is taking, then it may cause the drying of the skin. Then areas where is the very low temperature is there, as well as the humidity is high. So in that case also skin may become dry. Then skin diseases like eczema as well as psoriasis. So it can lead to the drying of the skin, but there is the particular part may be dried. Then metabolic conditions like diabetes, kidney disorders are there. Then certain allopathic drugs are there. So they may affect on the, your skin, or there is a side effects of the drug. Then dehydration caused due to the alcohol consumption and excessive sweating. So these are the probable causes of your drying of the skin. Then after that, what kinds of symptoms are there? Then we can say that there is this skin is dried. Generally, there is the affected skin appears like dull. Then peeled effect is there on the skin. Then itchy and painful skin may be there, depending on the your proportion of dry. Then redness, itchiness, then drip cracks may be possible. Sometimes bleeding may be there. Then gray ash on the your skin may appear, or the grayish color will be there, as well as fine lines and cracks are there. Skin can feel the looks as well as the roughs. So these are the probable symptoms on the, your dry skin. Then precautions. Generally, to avoid or to overcome this problem, first of all, we should follow the precautions, like do not take the too much shower. And generally, we can avoid the washing with the soap during every bath. So probably we should avoid the maximum utilization of the soaps, as well as the we can say showering also. Then choose non-alcohol based moisturizers. So whatever the moisturizers we are using, so we have to choose the non-alcohol based, because non-alcohol based means it should contain the maximum content of water. If we are using the alcohol based moisturizer, it means it will be evaporated very fastly. Then use sunscreen preparations to protect your skin. Then when soap is needed, use the gentle or the non-drying product type of soaps. So we can use the glycerin added soaps, or those soaps are having the good wetting property. That the kind of soaps we can use, or good moisturizing soaps. Then we can wear the sunscreen aprons regularly. Then we can massage the body with the herbal oils. So these are the various kind of precautions we can use. In case of Ayurveda, if we'll think through the Ayurveda, then there is a little bit different skin treatment is there. According to the Ayurveda, the skin dryness is a vata deformation. Generally, vata causes the dryness of the skin when it is vitiated because of the seasonal influences. For the treatment of the dry skin, Ayurveda suggests that they have prepared herbal creams like moisturizers, lotions. So these are all the products are, you can say, having a branded ones like Ayurveda Guru Vat. So instead of that, we can use the another type of moisturizers which are prepared one. Different types of humectants are there. We can choose them for the treatment of the your moisturizing cream. Now another terminology is there regarding the comedogenic. Now this is the little bit new technology terminology, or you might have heard about this technology terminology. This comedogenic means those ingredients or the those cosmetic products which can block or which can clog the pores of your skin, and because of the blocking of the skin, there might be chances that acne may be developed in the skin, or blackheads may be developed, or whiteheads may be developed on your skin. Simply, we can say these products, when we are using as a cosmetic material, so they may have that tendency to block the your skin pores, and because of that blocking, sebum may be blocked, and because of that, so many types of skin problems may be appear. The examples of that kind of material which can have the ability to block your pores are like coconut oil, neem oil, coca butter, shea butter. So these are the one examples, are routine examples of our general life.
Then what is meant by non-comedogenic? That non-comedogenic means vice versa, those material which are not having the tendency to block the your skin pores, so they are called as the non-comedogenic. And we should use such kind of material like grape seed oil is there, sunflower oil is there, then sweet almond oil is there. They can be used as a non-comedogenic material. Now another terminology is the dermatitis. It is also well known to all of you. Dermatitis is known as the eczema or inflammation of the skin. It is characterized by the itchy as well as erythematous, vascular and whipping and crusting patches on the skin. The term eczema is also commonly known as atopic type of dermatitis, and it may be called as the atopic eczema. The causes of dermatitis are unclear, and there are the, we can say, several environmental conditions are there. They may are responsible for causing of the dermatitis. Generally, it is estimated that due to the dysfunctional interplay between the immune system and the skin may be developed the such kind of dermatitis. Now, symptoms and signs of the dermatitis. When the dermatitis is there, so it may cause the redness of the skin, swelling, then intense itching may be possible, skin lesions are there, like red bumps, blisters may develop because of the continuous itching. Then skin lesions at the heel, scars may form over the affected area. So these are the signs and symptoms of the. Then these are the images showing the dermatitis. Then different types of dermatitis are there, like allergic types of dermatitis, then irritant contact dermatitis, atopic dermatitis, neurodermatitis, then nummular dermatitis, then seborrheic dermatitis, and stasis dermatitis. So this is about your types of skin, oily types, and your dermatitis. We'll see regarding the moisturizers.